Hi and welcome to another video from Class 47 Peter, and today we're here with a how-to video, which this will be the first how-to video in 2015. Now I can't promise how many of these how-to videos there are going to be this year, but hopefully, fingers crossed, there'll be more to follow. So I just blew my nose then. I've got a bit of a runny nose, so do excuse that. So today we're going to do a how-to video that I've been meaning to do for a while now. And today I'm going to show you how to paint cab interiors on locomotives. In this video, we'll be using two. We have the Ivatt Class 4 Flying Pig, which is made by Batman, of course, and the Hornby Main Range LNERP2 Coco the North. Now, the reason I'm doing two locos is because both cab interiors on these locos are different. As if I just show you there with the Class 4, you can see that the cab interior is different to the one of the P2. And this is the same case with any other loco. So that is why I've decided to do two locos in this one video. Besides, I think it will be more interesting as well. So what you'll need is some paint, which is Revel, and we have a can of gold paint, which is spray paint. Now I'm not going to spray the models gold. We'll see what I've got that for later. And you'll also need a cocktail stick or a needle. There isn't really much to it. Okay, no dilly dallying, let's get cracking. So first I think we will start off with the Hornby P2. So we'll move the Class 4 out of the way. And we will concentrate on the cab interior of the P2. So, the paints, you're going to need red, white, and gold. Now, I'm using the spray can because I don't have any other gold paint with me. So, that's why I'm using the spray paint. I will have to get some gold paint, but in the meantime, I've got this spray paint, but it still does work, as I have used it on other cab interiors that I've painted. Okay, so first we're going to paint the gauges and the dolls, and this is where the white paint comes in. Now I do not have much left, so I will have to get some more. And this is the gloss white. I do have some white paint, but that's been mixed into light blue colour, which I did before in one of my other build reviews, so there you go. But the gloss white, it still works just as well. Now the reason I'm using Revel paint is because, well, in my experience I find it dries quicker than Hornby paint, and I find it better to use, in my opinion. Okay, so I've lowered the camera down so you can actually see what I'm doing. Now do excuse if my giant hand gets in the way in some shots, but that won't really be able to be helped. Okay. So the gauges. Hang on a second, I think I'm going to have to need a flashlight for this, I think. Because, you know, it's not going to be easy to kneel down like this. Because now I've really can't see where the gauges and the dials are. So bear with me. Well, I've now got some light, which is it's one of those lights that you get off those straps that you strap to your head, which I took the strap off and I've sellotaped it onto the camera. A bit crude, but, you know, I've got to get some light on it so I can see what I'm doing. Okay, so now we can paint. Again, do excuse if any giant hands get in the way. Okay, so there we are. You can just about see where I put the first white paint. Okay. Okay, so there we are. So that's the white paint done. As you can just about see. And if there's any mistakes made, you can just go over it with a cocktail stick. So I've just got the camera up close to see the gauges and the dials that I've painted. Do excuse the awkward angle. Right, so this is where the gold spray paint comes in. There is some spray paint in there, as I've just sprayed it. I do recommend, if you use spray paint, you shake the can up first. And the reason why I've got gold spray paint is so I can paint the piping. I might need to put a bit more spray paint in this actually. There we are. Okay, so that's the piping done. That one's been touched up. Now there is some piping up there that I've got to reach to. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to raise this P2 up. Okay, so that's all those bits done. Now we're going to paint up the details using, well, the ones that I haven't painted yet that need to be red, using gravel red. So there we are. That's the cab detail on the P2 done. If I just switch the light off. Actually, no, keep it on. So you can see the details are now painted. The ridge you can just about make out, but either way, I'm very happy with that. Okay. Now we'll move on to the Ivatt Class 4. That's not what we did in the P2, we're going to paint the gauges first. And in this case there really isn't many to paint. There's one. There's two. There we go. There seems to be one at the top corner. I know I lifted away at the camera then, but I had to make sure I could see it properly. Okay, so the gauges and dials are now painted up. I'm just scraping the excess paint back into the paint pot. And so now we're going to use the red paint for the speedometer. There you are. So now it's the gold piping. So, paint pot under the Ivatt Class 4. Although in this case we might not have to do it. No, I don't think in this case we have to. My bad. Just having a quick sip of cherry cider there. and touch more or less sit with the Ivert Class 4. There's no those turning wheels that was with the P2 and what you see with other locos. Pardon. One thing I do need to do though, and I've only just noticed this, is I need to make one slight adjustment to the speedometer. I just need to go over it. In fact, I might just paint this. And there we are. That basically brings an end to this tutorial on painting cab details. And so that is all there is to this how-to video. There's not much paint required, and not even a brush is required for this really. Just a needle or a cocktail stick does the job just fine. And look at the results you get. You know, these cab interiors being hand painted, they are on par with Hornby's, to be honest. And so that basically sums up this how-to video. Being basic more or less, but it's shown you how to paint the cab interiors anyway. And I am aware that there are other videos that already show you how to paint cab interiors, but I thought I'd have a go at it and show you how it can be done. So thank you for watching, and I will see you again soon. Ta-ta for now.